Bloomers, you got plenty of time. But here we go, finally. This is the losers here. Losers semis, I believe, with Ikemen from the north from Hokkaido, running Giovanna with a new character named Dari Ino, a Guilty Gear veteran, a Korean who lives in Japan, who we claimed, and yeah. Ino God.
Used to live in Japan a long time ago, when in the late 2000s, mm-hmm. went back to Korea, came back.
Mm-hmm.
Now he's living out there in Osaka.
Yeah, he's West Coast. But here we go. Giovanna, very close range character, wants to get in on you. And the thing is, Ino as well, right? So Ino, he's got some zoning tools, but at the end of the day, she's going to have to get in eventually. So I think it's probably not too bad here for Ikemen. Keeping her distance. That move right there, that three DPs in a row. That little flip kick she does, it's not invincible, not a true DP, but as an anti-air is incredible.
Yeah, her hurt box dips really, really low. I think it's like below her knees.
Mm-hmm. And she gets a full combo, corner carry and everything. That's it. Run up 2S, counter hit. 2S, another really good poke for her. And against Dar, who's playing Ino, who's got Stroke the Big Tree, that low sweeping move, you know, that's a great counter. That one right there.
Yep.
Another one. So preemptive 2Ss from Ikemen. I gotta forget, we're on the PlayStation channel. I gotta dumb down my talk, huh? We gotta give you, we got the new players right there. That flip kick. We'll call it the flip kick, the DP right there. And there's
really leverages burst there just to be able to prevent the wall break. Back to mid screen.
Got him. We get a little setup too. And right back on a safe jump, I believe.
Guard.
Yeah, safe jump. I like it. Got a punish. Nice burst from Ikemen. You know, he wasn't gonna die off that, but.
Wow, and able to close it off with just that juggle?
All off that counter 2D, that sweep, it looks like nothing. I fought this character like 20 games before I even knew what was happening, right? I just get hit by stuff. I was like, what is going on? It's a little sweep. The dog. The dog, they say the dog doesn't do anything. The dog does everything in that sweep. If you look up the hitbox viewer.
It's like his hind foot just pokes out.
He just pauses and just like, boop. Hitbox is huge. Counter, you get a full combo like that because it brings him up in the air.
His reason for existence is just to be in that sweep
animation. To do a 2D, and that's all he needs. That's all he needs. So he used it right there as an anti-air, right? The move is so weird. It has no hurt box, just a big ol' attack. You can think of it almost like a projectile. So Dar was in the air, still hit him. Counter hit, full combo, death. And Ikemen, that's one. BlazBlue players rise up. Elvin Chad was right. That's it. BlazBlue players, we run this game now. The BB tag is stepping up too.
Yeah, I'm trying to think when we're wrong with Daru there. I mean, it's kind of harder to zone Giovanna, especially with Ino's toolkit.
Yeah.
It's weird to say that even because, you know, she has notes, she has horizontal chemical love, those kinds of attacks, but Gio is so good at being able to just weave, bob and weave past all that, get into that danger zone right up close. But
this
right
is Ino round.
Yeah, this is Ino round.
It happens sometimes, these offensive characters where it's just like, oh no.
That's exactly what I was talking about, right? You see Giovanna, she's able to dip under the HCL like that. Daru can't really rely on that move to be able to zone like that unless she's going to jump back like that and tag her out of her jump.
But that was crazy. Daru was at like 90% health, got tagged once and burst already. But that shows you like how intense he is, how afraid he is of letting Giovanna get started. But again, there's that DP, that anti-air, that flip kick from Giovanna. Very powerful tool.
Nice 40% conversion too. Made it look easy.
Yeah, the conversion, and you know, it is unsafe, but if you're airborne, a lot of moves in this game, if you block them in the air, you know, you cannot punish. So the second Ikemen sees Dar go up, he's going to start mashing on that.
What a check.
Wall break, hard knockdown. I feel like it was Cammy, right? Double dash in? No, goes for the air dash instead.
It's another situation like you were talking about right there. Then flip kick like that normally has plus frames, but then you block it in the air like that, especially Daru, the FD'd, and he's going to be locked in the blocks done even longer. Didn't get himself out the situation. Just like that. Instant air dash at round start.
Yeah, little combo jar from Ikemen. Still, you know, good start here. Got counter hit. Dar went for a reset rather than just getting a knockdown, and now we're getting started. No burst. You know, here we go.
Oh, yeah. Be able to check him out the reversal. He tried the reversal flip kick.
Goes for the super. Get the hard knockdown here. He's going to try and set something up, but Ikemen does that burst.
Dar fighting for his life. Trying to keep up the stroke pressure. Doesn't want to be able to go back.
He's going
to
grab
full screen.
No, never mind. Health is kind of low.
Dive. Ikemen.
That's plus. Spend 50, wants to stay right on top. Cross it, but he got out of the corner, right? That's good for Daru.
Oh, Daru had the jump. Got stand punched, anti-air. No. Now like this, Daru, please close this out.
Oh, no. Yeah, had it burst. He's afraid to do anything. He's just running away, not attacking at all.
Oh.
Hop, good check. Yeah, that's not plus after that. Good jump back.
Oh, God.
So that horizontal, that spike kick she does, you know, it's slow on startup, but if you block it, it's still, she's plus. It's still her turn right there. So the way you want to avoid that, neutral jump from Dar, good call out, able to fall down with a light punish. So 1-1, staying alive, but he's fighting for his life.
As in control as that felt for him, that was still super scary.
One burst. One burst, he lost control, and then it was like, uh-oh. running, fighting, fighting, running away.
Yeah, I think if Ikemen would have read that burst, it would have been over. You know, that burst in the corner is really what saved them, gave them the opportunity to be able to close out that game.
There's a thing about, I mean, most fighting games are like that too. A lot of matches can come down to one decision.
One read.
But this game is so fast because the damage is so high. There's way more rounds that come down to that. It's like, man, I guessed wrong. 870%. Damn.
Game three here.
And this is losers. Somebody's going home. There's prize money for all top eight. But again, you want to get as far as you can to get more money.
You see now Ikemen put it in Daru's head that he's willing to round start and just jump in like that with those jump kicks. Daru fishing for 6P at the ground start. I wonder if they will change that up next round.
Beautiful backdash on the die. A little bit slow, and there it is.
Wow.
Yeah, so like Angie, for example, Angie got an anti-move with Ko, but that move only hits players in the air. So even though this flip kick from Ikemen is an anti-air move, it works on the ground as well. Oh. Ooh, that was almost sick. If he blocked that, he would have been plus, but he ducked and tried to stand the whiff punishment, still a little bit too slow. Life lead here for Ikemen and no burst right now for Daru, but he's playing a very aggressive character in Ino. If he gets 50 for command grab, show me the grab.
Damn. Yeah, classic counterplay there, just wanting to just do the stand punch like that. Give a quick anti-air, just knows Daru's gonna go high. Back to the wall though, goes low.
Good luck.
No! Ooh, the double over, yeah.
So he's 50 meter, he had a defensive burst ready. He just had to guess right one time, guessed wrong. Double overhead. Daru didn't have meter to kill, but knew it would be enough, and there it is, that dash S. Double dash in, like, what? Where is the space? What happened?
Cross up again. This time, same side? No. Plus frames.
Good interrupt here with a 6B. Yeah, when Jinma gets started, there's a lot of cross-ups like that. You know, it's really intimidating, but it's not a lot of damage, so you just don't get flustered. You have to avoid the big damage starters like that 2D. Nice. And now we got space. Both players with burst. Little trade right there, the 6H, but you can get a combo after that. Double, yeah. Ikemen really knows this matchup. You know, Dara's trying to get some little pressure resets, but they're not real. He's ready every time. Reverse the super. Here's the schmicks. No!